name. I'm Shazia Mirza, and I'm a stand-up comedian. But when I was growing up, no one expected me to ever become a comedian or ever be on the stage. And I never knew if it was ever going to be possible for me. When I was growing up, though, what I really wanted to be was a big, glamorous Hollywood star like Marilyn Monroe. I wanted to sing, dance, and be a star. My job is that I'm a stand-up comedian, and I suppose people know me as this Muslim woman who does stand-up comedy. Well, when I was growing up, what was expected of me was that I was a Muslim girl brought up in a Pakistani household. My parents were very strict and I had three brothers, and my brothers were treated totally different from me. And what they wanted for me is to be a doctor, a dentist, a lawyer or a solicitor, you know, because there aren't enough Asian doctors in Britain. And they wanted me to be that because it was a respectable thing to do in the community. And then they wanted me to get married to a nice Muslim Pakistani man and have kids. And then my parents would be perfectly proud of me, and that was their dream. Tomorrow's the day I've been dreading. I knew it would happen one day. Tomorrow's the day of my wedding, and I only found out today. My parents arranged it all for me. They tell me how lucky I am. But when I complain, they ignore me. They say, listen, dear, there's nothing to fear. Just lie back and think of Islam. In my mind, I knew that I wanted to end up on the stage, but how was I going to do that? I don't know. It was a difficult journey because, you know, the only freedom I really had was going to school. I went to ballet lessons for a while, but then my dad wouldn't let me go anymore because people in the community started talking, and it was seen as a really bad thing to do ballet. And on a Friday night, all my friends, all my white English friends, they would go to ballet and tap, and I'd have to go to mosque lessons and learn the Quran. And when you're 10 years old, you just think, I just want to be like my other friends. I want to do tap dancing, you know. My parents think they're liberal. That's why tonight they said, this is your husband, say hello, now go off back to bed. The man was nearly 50 and too big for the chair. And when he smiled, his tongue came out and licked his nostril hair. My self-portrait is about all the things I wanted to be when I was a child, like, I adored Marilyn Monroe, and I wanted to be a Hollywood film star, and I used to watch all the Hollywood movies, and I wanted to sing, and I wanted to do ballet, and I wanted to do tap, and I wanted to be on the stage and be an entertainer. And it's about all the things that I wanted to be when I was a child, and that all those things are still part of me. I'm not just what people think I am, but it's what I think I am. My parents were looking for ages for suitable husbands to be. In the Islamabad yellow pages, there were men aged 19 to 73. There were doctors and lawyers and dentists and shopkeepers ad nauseam. But you'd have to be non-compos mentis to fly thousands of miles, to walk down the aisle, just lie back and think of Islam. I still have the traditions that I was brought up with. I'm still very religious. I still believe in my religion and my culture, but it doesn't stop me doing the things I want to do. I think that sometimes people think that you're bound by your traditions and you're bound by your religion, and you're not really. That should actually give you more freedom, and it's given me a lot of freedom. That's my self-portrait. What's yours?